Good morning, one and all. This is Sri Kumar, Associate Professor, BC Department. Today I am going to present the topic radiation intensity in antenna wave propagation. Radiation intensity. So, first of all, we have to know what is meant by radiation intensity. Radiation intensity is nothing but it is the concentration of the antenna beam or the waves, electromagnetic waves which are coming from the antenna in a particular direction, that is called as radiation intensity. So the radiation intensity is independent of the length. Radiation intensity is independent of length, direction, length and direction. So, for suppose if you are focusing the antenna, with a complete aperture, that focus beam will be radiated into all the surroundings of the area which is covering, but that intensity of that particular antenna which is being received by the receiving antenna or the destination, the destination may receive only part of the beam which is being focused. So that intensity of that particular antenna which is focusing the electromagnetic wave is considered as less, because it is unable to focus the complete beam from the from the antenna is in the particular direction is very less. As the focus of that particular antenna is less, then we will consider it as the intensity in that particular direction is less. So the radiation intensity is it will be depending upon the directivity of the antenna. So intensity of the particular antenna will be high when the directivity of that antenna is high. If the antenna directivity is not high, that means what? If the directivity of the antenna is not focused in a particular direction, but it is focused in all the directions. If it is an isotropic antenna, then the radiation from that particular antenna will be focused in all the directions. And then what happens in a particular direction? Concentration will be very less, then obviously the directivity of that particular antenna will be less. So directivity is then given by the formula. It is the radiation intensity. Radiation intensity of isotropic antenna. So this directivity is then given by the radiation intensity of the test antenna. If it is considered phi max, that is the radiation intensity in that of the test antenna is considered as phi max, and then the radiation intensity of the isotropic antenna is given by S by 4 pi. If it is given by S by 4 pi, then it will be 4 pi times of phi max by S. This is given by the directivity of that particular antenna. So the radiation intensity and directivity are both related, where radiation intensity will be depending upon the directivity of antenna. Then if the radiation intensity is more, obviously directivity will also will be more for the antenna. So then we have to consider the gain of the antenna. So what is the gain? So next parameter what we have to consider is gain of the antenna. So gain is given by, so gain parameter is given by the focus of that particular antenna beam from the radiating surface of the antenna in a particular direction where it is having more intensity. It is having more intensity at that particular point, then it is considered that the gain of that particular antenna is high. That means obviously if the directivity of the antenna is good and which is having more intensity, that is having more radiation intensity in that particular direction. For example, if it is a particular point which is called the observation point and this is the antenna location where the antenna is located from here, and if the focus of this antenna along this observation point is having a good directivity with a particular beam with theta, then it is considered as having a good directivity and obviously the gain parameter will be high. Then the gain of that particular antenna is given by phi max by phi minimum. That is the observation point mere maximum output by observation point minimum output, which will give you the gain in a particular direction of that particular antenna. So depending upon the type of antenna, test antenna we are using, the gain parameter will be changing. The test antennas which we are using can be different types of antennas, like a small dipole, it can be a dipole, it can be a monopole. You can use a monopole antenna, you can use a dipole antenna, and you can use a helical antenna, and you can also use several other types of antennas like antenna arrays. Every antenna is having its own gain parameter depending upon the isotropic radiator. Compared with the isotropic radiator, the gain of that particular antenna will be considered. So now if you are observing the particular point with surface, that means if you are observing a particular point in a spherical coordinate system by considering the three coordinates, if you want to observe the radiation of that particular point, that means the intensity, radiation intensity of that particular point with respect to this coordinate system, where it is the x, it is y, and if you are considering it as a z direction, then this spherical coordinate system, in this spherical coordinate system, this will be considered as at a particular point. If you are observing with respect to a particular point like this, and this point is P is here, and if you are observing with respect to this particular point, the angle made by this z axis with respect to that particular point, it is called as theta, and this is called as elevation angle, R is the radius. R is the radius of that particular antenna steering with respect to that particular point, and theta is the angle made, which is called the elevation angle, and this is called azimuthal angle. Phi is called as azimuthal angle. So in a spherical coordinate system, the radiation intensity of the particular point is measured with respect to r, theta, comma, phi. These are the factors which we have to consider, where phi is called the azimuthal angle, this is called elevation angle, and the r is the radius of the particular point with respect to z direction. So these are the three points which should be considered. Now, another parameter we have to consider is pattern. Pattern followed. Okay. So, generally, the pattern followed by the antenna is different for different frequencies. So, depending upon the frequency of operation, the patterns followed will also be changed. So, depending upon the pattern followed, the three factors which you have to consider is the one thing is called as main lobe concentration. This is called the main lobe concentration, and this is called side lobe concentration. This is called side lobe concentration, and all these lobes other than this main lobe, they are called as side lobes. They are called as side lobes, and this is called as main lobe. The pattern will be observed like this, where it is called the side lobe and this is the main lobe. And if the main lobe concentration, that means the intensity of the main lobe is decreasing, then your side lobe concentration will increase. So we have to see that for any antenna, for a good radiating antenna, always the main lobe concentration should be high compared to that of the side lobe concentration. And these lobes are called as back lobes. These are called back lobes. Okay, these are called back lobes. So you have to see the pattern. The pattern will be changed from particular antenna to another antenna. The depending upon the frequency of operation, the patterns will be changing. So whatever it may be, the any general considerations of these patterns will be considered as main lobe, side lobe, and the back lobe concentrations for these patterns. Okay. So now we have to consider for this particular antenna, when you are getting a main lobe concentration, what is off power beamwidth? We have to consider two points. One is called as off power beamwidth. Another one is called as beamwidth of first nerves. So the tangential values which is occurring at this particular lobe, at this point, this is called off power beamwidth. The beamwidth existing between the two tangential values to tangential lines for this main lobe, this represents the off power beamwidth. Okay, right. Next, what next we have to consider? Beamwidth of first nerves. So beamwidth of first nerves is nothing but the point where the line touches this first main lobe. The point where it touches the main lobe, this will give you the beamwidth of first nerves. This is called beamwidth of first nerves. Okay. So then another factor what you have to know is resolution. Resolution is nothing but two times of beamwidth of the first nerves is called as resolution. Resolution of the antenna. Another factor what you are seeking, resolution of antenna. So what is meant by resolution? Resolution is nothing but it is the clarity of that particular, that means how much clarity it is that particular electromagnetic wave is able to produce in that particular direction will be denoted by means of the resolution. So this resolution is nothing but off power beamwidth of first nerves by two times of beamwidth of first nerves. Two times, that means into four. Beamwidth of first nerves by two into beamwidth of first nerves by two will give you the resolution factor. This is called the resolution factor. And another parameter what you have to know is antenna efficiency. Antenna efficiency. What is meant by antenna efficiency? Antenna efficiency will depending upon the main parameters called as gain parameter, directivity parameter. Okay, so efficiency of the antenna. Efficiency of the antenna. How you can say that a particular antenna is efficient in transmitting the electromagnetic waves from one point to particular point? So the efficiency will be depending upon its aperture area. For example, this is the aperture area of that particular antenna, and this aperture area, this is called aperture area, okay, small a. Then in this aperture area, only some part of this effective aperture area which can radiate. Not all the surface can radiate, only some part can radiate, and which will be used to focus that radiation in the particular direction.